I'm going to show you two techniques that will help you remove the braces off an image. We're going to work with this file. It contains two images. They're really the same. The only difference is that one has noise and the other does not. We're going to work with the image without noise first, and then I'm going to show you what to do in case your image has noise, since some of the techniques I'm going to show you will smooth out some of that noise. But anyway, so we have our smile layer. I'm going to create a new layer. It's going to be a blank layer, and that's the layer that we're going to work on, because we always want to work non-destructively and we don't want to destroy the pixels of the original layer. So first, let me show you what you're probably thinking that I'm going to do, or what you've probably seen other people do, which is use either the clone stamp tool or the healing brush tool. And they both do an okay job. For example, the spot healing brush tool, to be exact, I can click and drag, and at some point I'm going to start getting rid of the braces, and you know, that can work okay. It looks fine. By the way, I'm working on this layer here, and I have sample all layers selected so that I can sample the layers below and I can generate the new pixels on this blank layer. But anyway, I'm going to keep painting, and I'm going to get rid of the braces as best as I can. So, you know, that looks okay. I can also use the clone stamp tool, hold Alt, Option on the Mac, click on a place to sample from, and then clone from that place. Again, I have sample all layers selected. So I generate the pixels on this new layer. So things are looking okay, and I can spend a little more time sampling from different areas and cloning out the different areas of the braces. But the problem is that even though it may look okay to the naked eye, it's really not that good. You can sort of see here how I have different shadows and different colors in areas where there shouldn't be. And it becomes more obvious when I create a curves adjustment layer and make the image darker. I'm gonna drag this down and look at how bad the cloning and the healing brush tool make the teeth look. There's a lot of different values and shadows and things that really shouldn't be there. So I usually don't use the clone or healing brush tool when removing braces or things like that from teeth, because it doesn't always generate a good result. So what I'm going to do instead is I'm going to delete this layer and create a new one just to start from scratch. And I'm going to show you two different things that I like to do. The first is actually very simple. Select the brush tool and paint with the color of the teeth. So I'm just going to hold Alt, Option and a Mac, click on an area right above the teeth, and just simply start painting. And by the way, I have the opacity pressure sensitivity set on my Wacom tablet. If you don't have a Wacom tablet, you can use a mouse. Just bring down the opacity and bring down the flow, and then just build on the color of the teeth. So I'm just gonna select different areas and paint. And if I enable the curves adjustment layer again, notice that it looks much smoother and you don't get all those dark tones around the teeth. And I can just keep painting to remove the braces. And when I get to the edge of the teeth, like an area there, I'm going to zoom in so you can see what I'm going to do. I'm just going to sample a color that's on the edge, the darkest color, then bring the size of the brush down by hitting the left bracket key on my keyboard and just painting that in. Do the other side. And if I zoom out, you'll see the result. That's before, that's after. I'm not gonna take the time to do all the braces on each individual tooth in this tutorial, but I will show you some of the more complicated areas. That way you know what to do. So I'm gonna do this one here and then the ones back here. So for this one, I would just follow the contour of the teeth. So I'm just gonna hold Alt, Option on the Mac, click on a place to sample from, and then do what I've been doing, just keep painting and sort of follow that contour there. Now do that here. And then up here, same thing. I would remove it by selecting the color right above that and just paint it out. in this area back here, these are all shadows, so I can actually just get away with painting with black. So I'm going to select this dark color here. It's not quite black. And then just paint those away. And just the lip, select the color of the lip. And bring some of that color back. It might be a little too light, so I'm just going to make it darker and maybe select this darker color here and add more to the shadow. All right, so something like that. I'm gonna zoom out just so we could see, and it's looking much better. Obviously, you wanna take a little more time than what I did there, and maybe come back and take some of the colors from maybe the darker areas here in the corner, and then just paint the outline of the tooth here. And if it's not dark enough, maybe you can darken that up. There we go. Fit to screen, and that looks much better. So this is before and this is after. And again, for this one, you would do exactly the same thing. This is the last one I'm gonna do, and then we're gonna move on to the bottom ones because we're gonna use a different technique. So I'm just gonna sample the color right below that and just paint as we've been doing. So I'm gonna go a little bit faster on this one just because you already got the hang of it. And again, select one of these darker colors here for the edge of the tooth here. So something like that. And I'm going to zoom out. And you can keep adding shadows if you think it needs them. And I think it needs them in this case. So I'm going to select the brush tool again. Just maybe select one of these darker colors, and I have pressure sensitivity turned on, so I can paint very lightly there to add a little shadow there. So that's before and that's after. I'm also noticing that there's a big difference in color here between the top of this tooth and then the bottom, so I'm just going to select the color up here and just sort of integrate that color a little bit better. So there's no sharp edges, so that's before and that's after. And for this bottom part, what we're gonna do is actually create a new layer just so we can have the layer for the top teeth and the layer for the bottom. So on layer two, which is bottom, and I'll just rename them accordingly. Bottom, top. I'm gonna do a different technique, and I'm gonna, again, zoom in just so we can see it a little bit better. And I'm just gonna use the smudge tool, this one here. And I'm gonna sample all layers. And all I'm gonna do is simply smudge the teeth way down. And I know I'm going into the lip, and that's okay. I'm gonna do that for all of them. That one I'll just paint out, just like I did the ones on the top here. And what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna go back into each individual one and just sort of tap and go to the side there so we don't have those streaks. So it's just a little bit smoother. So I'm just tapping and going from side to side, just a tiny little bit. Something like this. And now that I have that, I'm gonna zoom out and I'm gonna hold Alt, Option on the Mac and click on the layer mask to hide everything inside of that layer. I'm gonna zoom in again, and I'm just gonna paint with white in areas where I see the braces. I'm gonna actually remove the pressure sensitivity on the opacity just because it's making me go slower than I wanna go. So I can just start painting these areas back in. And you obviously would do that for all of them. And take your time when you're going right up against the lip here, right on that edge. That's where you really gotta be careful. So what I'm gonna do here is just go go back into the actual layer, not the layer mask. Make sure that the focus is not on the mask. Make sure it's on the actual layer thumbnail. Hold Alt Option and a Max, select the color, and then paint that away. And actually, for it to show, I gotta obviously paint with white on the layer mask. So then now I'm gonna paint with white on the layer mask to make that show. And there it is. And one other thing I want to show you before we finish this tutorial is, if you want to add more of those highlights in the teeth, you can do two things. You can actually use the clone stamp tool. So add a new layer, sample highlights from an area, and just paint them in another area. Or you could also simply select the brush tool, select that highlight color, bring the brush size down by tapping the left bracket key on the keyboard, and you could just paint your own highlights as well. So you can do either or, whatever works better in your case. And this is the highlight we created there, right here. And what we're gonna talk about now really quick is, what do we do if the original image has some noise, has some texture? So let me just go ahead and turn off the smile layer here. And right beneath that, we have the same image, but it contains a lot more texture. And obviously the work that we've done doesn't translate over very well, because now the paint and the smudging smooth everything out. So what we need to do is add some of the texture back onto these layers. So just for the sake of saving time, I'm just gonna hold Shift and click on all three and press Control E, Command E on the Mac to merge all of them into one layer. You probably don't want to do that in your own project. You probably want to apply the effect that I'm about to apply now to each individual layer. But just to save a little bit of time, we're going to do it all in one layer. So we have the layer here with the adjustments. And what you can do is go into Filter, Noise, Add Noise, and just adjust the noise accordingly so that it resembles the noise on your image. I'm just tapping the up key on the keyboard to add some noise. I'm just gonna leave the noise set to 5.64 for now. Press OK, and if you think it's too much, just go into Edit, Fade, and then you can even adjust the opacity from here, and that might be a little bit easier to adjust. So in this case, maybe right about here, if I fit to screen, then you'll see now that the areas that we painted and smudge contain some of that noise. So that's what you want to do for your image. And this is the final result. Make sure that you leave all your comments or questions down below.